Hi guys, it's Jen and welcome back to my channel. So I am going to be testing out this Luxe makeup brush cleaner. And if you are like me, you hate cleaning your makeup brushes pretty much like everybody. That's why you're clicking on this video. So I have tried a lot of different makeup cleaning products. I have tried the Cinema Secrets, and honestly, I don't like this stuff, guys. I know that a lot of people like this, but I don't like this. I found that this stains my brushes, so I don't like this at all. I have this big giant container, and yes, I've used quite a bit of it, but I've had this for like, I'm gonna say a year, and I do not like this. I honestly bought one of these little scrubbing pads, and I was like, I'm gonna just use this instead of that brush cleaner because I did not like it. I know a lot of people swear by that, but honestly, I liked this better than that. So now I am going to see if I like this brush cleaner better than that, because I absolutely hate having to dry my brushes at night. And I just got this in the mail earlier today, so I am excited to test it out. And I am going to show you guys with their cleansing solution, which comes with it. So I'm going to show you everything that comes with it, but I'm going to do like kind of a test with this because I've got a big cup of water here. I've got a bucket to dump everything in, and I have cleaning wipes to clean the bowl out with. I am going to be testing this out and seeing how well it works and what works best with it. So yes, I'm going to put the box away. It does come with a booklet to tell you how to use everything. It comes with a bowl. This part removes from it. This is glass. This is not plastic. It comes with this cleaning solution. And then it also comes with a charging cord. It does not come with the adapter to charge it, but you can just use one of your old phones. Chargers or your current phone charger. It comes with this little station. And so this is the brush cleaning product. Basically, this is what does all the work for you. The reason this one intrigued me so much is because it has three different settings, so I can actually, you know, have different speeds for different brushes. That way I'm not having the same speed to clean every single brush and possibly tearing up my brushes, because that's what I was kind of scared of. So then you do get, like I said, this little charging station and then eight different size container things to put your brushes in. So this charges it. I got this today, like I said, and it took about 2.5 hours to charge this. This did have like battery power already in it, but I charged it and it took 2.5 hours for it fully to turn green from the time that I opened it. I also did notice with this, it had like a slight ringing sound while it was charging. It wasn't very like noticeable, but I don't know, like I can hear like high-pitched noises like that a lot of times. I can't hear other things very well, but high-pitched noises I can tend to hear. You didn't really hear it unless you were like really close to it, but like when I was charging it, I get close to make sure that I docked it properly. That way I could, you know, make sure it was gonna charge and it wasn't gonna tear it up. So like I said, this does come with three different settings, but I did want to put that out there so you guys can know about how long it takes to charge fully after you guys get it in the mail, if you do buy it. I think this product retails for, I'm thinking around like $60 some, and I did get it off Amazon. I paid $24.99 for it. So I definitely say wait until you can get it from Luxe for a deal, because I definitely got a deal. I was looking on eBay, and the Style Pro is like very expensive with shipping. I got free shipping with this and I only paid $24.99. Then you add additional tax, so it was probably around $26 for my, you know, state taxes and stuff. So I don't think that's bad at all. Yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and jump into me testing this out. I'm just gonna tilt the camera so you guys can see everything that I'm doing with this, and that way you're getting a good look at it too. So we're gonna hope that this turns out right. So let's get into the testing the camera. Okay guys, so this is the charger. This is the bowl, of course. I have a thing here full of water, so I'm just gonna pour some in. And I know it says not to pour that much. This is warm water, so I'm just gonna pop this back on. It comes with this little booklet here. Basically, it tells you that you can actually use baby shampoo and things like that to do your brushes. So it has all these steps in here, all the instructions. I've already read all of this, so I'm not gonna like read all of it while I do it. So basically, yeah. So the three different cleaners I am going to use, I'm going to obviously use their cleansing solution. I'm going to use the Real Techniques Brush Cleansing Gel. And then I'm also going to be using some baby shampoo from Shea Moisture. So these are the three products that I'm going to be testing out, and I have a ton of dirty brushes. So what I'm going to do is first, I want to test out with this really ugly brush right now because it is coated with foundation. So of course I'm going to be doing a test with this, and I'm going to use their solution. So I'm just going to put in a few drops. I'll put in four drops. Go down. Oh, it put more. All right, so I'm going to find a holder. That one, it kind of fits in, but I wonder if it should be tighter. I don't know, it fits in this one. So we will see. So then I'm just gonna attach this little piece. I can feel it touching my brush. So it doesn't feel like these are gonna be really hard to get off. I have watched several videos where people have a hard time getting these brushes off. So it says basically to, oh goodness, I turned it on. All right, so basically it tells you to just dip your, oh goodness. Okay, dip your brush down in the solution, and you can already see. If you are clean, you look clean for the most part, if you guys can see it. It was like covered in foundation. I think I feel like I needed more water. I don't know if you guys can tell, but it's not even like full, but the brush is actually pretty dry. It's not fully dry, but I don't think that it's fully clean. If you can see right there, there's a little bit of foundation left on it. For the most part, it's clean. I'm actually gonna add a little bit more water because I don't think I added enough. So I'm gonna. I don't know, I still don't feel like it's clean. It looks dirty still. So I don't know. But the water is like really, really filthy. Like I honestly would not want to use this again. So I don't like their cleanser. Maybe I didn't put enough in there, but I don't feel like my brush is clean. It does feel pretty dry, but it feels like it's a little bit wet still. All right, I am gonna go ahead and drop some of this Real Techniques gel. So I'm gonna drop this in first before I do the water. I actually really do not like this cleanser. So that is a good generous amount. So their solution, I only put like five drops. So now we're gonna go this Real Techniques gel and see how it works. So added a little bit more water in it this time, and we will see. This It Cosmetics brush, I think I'll probably be, no, that colander, that one, no, I'll be using the same one. So this colander is a little more snug. So we're gonna go in with this little thingy here. Oh my god, this thing is not clean at all. This thing is still filthy. Can you guys see this? Alright, and it's like sprayed my brush. This thing is still filthy. Still filthy, guys. We are still not clean. We're just dirty. Like, really dirty. Like I said, I do not like that brush cleaner anyway. Baby shampoo here, guys, so you guys can see it. Like I said, my thing is fully charged. So you can see right there, very good amount of baby shampoo. My water is warm. I'm gonna add the baby shampoo and the water together. Maybe I'll give it a little bit more water. I don't know, that's a lot of water. Okay, let's try this again. I'm just kind of dip it down in here and turn it on. So we will see. That's a little bit cleaner in the brush. Still wet. Actually, it's a lot cleaner. A lot cleaner than it was. Oh goodness, my cap came off. The water is not as dirty either, so I'm gonna try it again. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Okay, we are finally clean. So that is actually clean, it's dry. Can use it on the towel, nothing is coming off. So it's finally clean, guys, after several attempts and different shampoos. So far, I'm liking my baby shampoo the best. My final thoughts on this product are, I like it, but it has some cons. So yes, I am going to continue using this. I am going to use it to clean my brushes because it does make it a lot easier. My cons with this product are, I don't like the fact that it says it's going to take 10 seconds to clean your brushes, because it does not take 10 seconds. It takes, you know, it says supposedly 10 seconds to wash them, 10 seconds to dry them. The 10 seconds to dry them pretty much is a general for every single brush that I cleaned. To wash is a different story. That all depends on how much shampoo or solution you use, or how much water you use. So with that, you just kind of have to figure it out for yourself, like what is actually going to clean your brushes. So that is kind of a testing. Is it going to work? Is it not going to work? I don't like the fact that this bowl is glass. I wish that it was plastic, or I don't know, maybe a thicker glass, something that if I just accidentally, you know, get up really quick, I'm not going to drop this and it shatter everywhere and then me have to like reorder another one of these, or possibly order a cheap one off eBay possibly. I don't know if they have these bowls on eBay to where you can buy them. I'm sure they probably do. If you haven't invested in that yet, eBay, China sellers, you need to. We need those bowls. The only other concern that I would have is that my brushes over time would start fraying. This one, I'm not 100% for sure, so I'm not gonna blame it on the system, but there is like one single hair sticking up. So I don't know if that's because it took me a long while to clean this one or what, because I had to do this one several times. I think it took me about probably 2 minutes, a minute and a half to actually clean this brush. So, I mean, I guess, you know, and that's with drying it also, you know, lift my brushes out all night, it would be like the next day and I wouldn't even know if this brush was like fully clean or not. So it is nice to have this and to easily dry them. I feel like that would be the number of concern, that I would possibly fray my brushes over time and then I actually would be replacing brushes. So that is just basically kind of like a test of time to see if it's actually going to do that or not. But in general, I like this product. I do feel like it is definitely a good buy and something that I will continue to use. If you guys have any questions or you want to see me clean any more brushes, just let me know and I'll make another video of just me cleaning makeup brushes and using this and using different water, you know, soaps and things like that. Also, this cleaning solution, I do feel like it works, but when you run out of this, it's definitely not worth it to buy this again. They say this is a $24 value. I'm sorry, I don't feel like this is that good. I definitely liked my Shea Moisture Baby Shampoo a lot, lot better. So, I don't know what you use for, you know, to clean your brushes, but you can always use baby shampoo, and I feel like this works really well, you know, to clean them. It works better than this, actually, which, I mean, this did work. I'm not going to say it didn't work, but I feel like I had to use a good amount of this versus a good amount of this, and I'm not going to pay $24 for this tiny bottle when I have a humongous bottle of baby shampoo that I can use. This system does say that you don't need to use dish soap with cleaning your brushes, so, I mean, that's kind of up to you if that's what you generally use. It does advise against that, so yes, that is the end of this. I do feel like it is worth the buy, and I do definitely like it. Like I said, I'm a little nervous about the longevity of my brushes, in the system, but it's like a thing with only time will tell. So I hope you guys really liked this video. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and share, and let me know what you guys think of this system. Are you guys going to buy it? Or are you just going to go out there and find one of those eBay dupes for the system and the Style Pro? All right, until next time. Bye, guys.